Hey guys, what's up? I'm Palak Lakhani. In this channel, I make educational videos focusing mainly on studying, working and living in Germany. So if you are new here, consider subscribing. So in today's video, we have Nikita Verma with us. She recently got her visa approved from Hyderabad jurisdiction. So I thought of making this video so that those who are applying from Hyderabad jurisdiction can get information about how the entire visa procedure takes place. She will be giving us all the information in detail. So without wasting any further time, let's get started with today's video. Right. Hi Nikita, first of all,
hi.
Channel.
Thank you.
Could you please introduce yourself to the viewers?
Yes, sure. Hi everyone, I'm Nikita. I'm from Telangana. I'm a class of 2020 and I recently completed my final semester examinations. So I got admit from Martin Luther University, Halle-Wittenberg for polymer material science. So my visa appointment was on 20th of August at VFS Hyderabad. So it was at 8:23 a.m.
Okay, and when did you reach at the venue?
I reached there by 8 in the morning.
Okay.
But I was allowed inside the building at 8:20 exactly.
Okay. So, what would you suggest students? Should they go a bit early in case there is some problem?
Yeah, I think they should be at least like 10 to 15 minutes early because, you know, you have your temperature checks, then you have your documents verified. You know, this verification letter, you get this confirmation letter from the VFS Hyderabad after booking a slot. So you need to get that checked at the security guard. So you need to go in advance, like for 10 or 15 minutes.
Okay. So what all things did you submit to the security?
Only this confirmation letter from VFS that you have booked an appointment at the VFS for your national German visa and then the time.
Okay. But you are allowed to carry your mobile phones and everything with you, right?
Yes. There is a bag check at the entrance. But then you are allowed to carry your mobiles. You can carry your mobiles, but you don't have to use it. You cannot use it in the inside.
Oh, okay. Great. Where did you have to go after entering the building?
So after like getting your document checked at the security guard, you're sent inside. And at the inside, you have to go to the third floor at VFS Hyderabad.
Okay.
At the third floor, at first you have your temperature check. Then you are made to sanitize your hands and all. Then you have a bag check. And the next thing you do is you have separate sections for different countries. So you are sent to the German section and then there you are given a cue card, like you have to go in order. But then at my appointment, I was the first person to go there. So I was called immediately.
So you were lucky enough.
Yeah, I was lucky enough.
Okay, great. So that means you didn't have to wait much for your turn, right?
Yes, I didn't have to wait much.
Okay, great. What are the next steps that took place there?
So after going to the counter, the first thing you do is they give you a checklist of all the documents you need. So you have to arrange two sets of all those documents in order and then submit it to the member there. So they also give some additional documents also, which are not mentioned in the checklist. So you have to fill them there, like your maybe contact details, and some other details, your signature and all, and submit it there.
Okay.
So after submitting these documents in order, you are made to pay the fee. You have to pay the fee. So it is actually 6,600, the VFS service fee. But then you have to pay additional fee for like courier facilities and then SMS. So it is a total of like 7,200 approximately.
Okay.
You also have an option of premium lounge or something, but I don't think that is very much necessary because I don't think there is anything difference, much difference of like services, anything.
Yeah.
So if you have to like book an appointment in the VFS, the first thing you have, your eligibility criteria is first thing you have to have an unconditional admit and then a physical presence certificate. So if you are having only these two, only then you can book it VFS Hyderabad or else you have to go to German Consulate Chennai.
Okay.
So the next thing is, if you are applying for a loan, in case you have a tuition fee, you have to show a receipt of your tuition fee. In case someone else is sponsoring for your money, then you have to show a sponsorship affidavit.
Okay.
And in case your language of instruction is English, then you have to prove your English language proficiency. If it's German, you have to prove your German language proficiency as well.
Okay. What were all these Xerox copies that you had to submit? And which document was needed to be submitted in original hard copy?
Nothing in original. They might check your originals just in case they have any doubt if your originals are present with you or not. But you don't have to submit any original to VFS. You only submit photocopies.
Okay. And could you list all the photocopies that you submitted then?
Yeah. The first thing you have to submit is your national visa application form. It's like in total 8 pages. You can get it in india.diplo.de on the German consulate website. Then the second thing is motivation letter or cover letter. So in my case, they asked for any one of these, but that might be different. They might ask for both as well.
Okay.
So it varies. So for me, it was only cover letter. So I mentioned all the details like why I'm going to Germany. Then if I have any tuition fee, my language of instruction and the documents I am submitting. So that was motivation letter. And then the third document I submitted was my university admit and a physical presence.
Okay.
Then English language proficiency, IELTS. If you are not providing IELTS for your university, then you have to get a letter from your university stating that you don't have to submit IELTS because your education earlier was in English in that case.
Okay.
And then you have to provide a confirmation of blocked account, 10,236 euros. Okay. In case you don't have this confirmation of blocked account, you have to at least submit a proof that you have transferred the required money.
Okay.
Then it is your school certificates, your school leaving certificates, then your diploma and your bachelor's. I am not a graduate yet, so I submitted all individual semester mark certificates. But if you are a graduate, you have to submit your provisional degree as well.
Okay.
Along with all the semester marks.
Yeah.
Then you to submit.
You have to show the transcript, right? Which you get at the end of the semester.
Okay. Yes. In case you don't have that, you are a graduate, like 2020, if you don't have the final degree, you have to show a bona fide certificate stating that you are a student of so-and-so university in the last semester, studying the last semester. You also have to submit a travel insurance, which is like 6 months from your date of travel.
Mm-hmm.
In case you have a tuition fee, you also have to submit the pay slip that you have paid the tuition fee.
Okay.
Yeah.
Next thing which I would like to ask you is, what were the questions which you were asked by the visa officer?
I was asked nothing actually at VFS Hyderabad. It was nothing. It might actually vary from day to day. On my day, they didn't ask me a single question.
But I like, think you were the first one. That's why maybe they didn't want to trouble you.
Yeah. Maybe it was quite different for VFS Hyderabad and VFS Chennai actually.
Oh, okay.
They asked many questions for students in VFS Chennai, but it was different in VFS Hyderabad. Awesome. We weren't asked any questions.
So like you just went there, submitted the documents and then that's it?
Yeah, that's all. It was quite easy in VFS Hyderabad actually.
Okay. Recently I saw in many groups and I also read on some pages that there was a change in this block account money. Like initially it was 853.
Yes.
Then it increased to like I guess 861.
61.
And then
yes.
863, I guess.
Yes.
So, what amount did you have to show to them?
I showed them 10,236 euros. It was like approximately 853 per month. So after my appointment was done, for after almost like 20 days, this news came out stating that you have to increase your blocked account money. There was a lot of confusion, but they didn't ask for any. Even for visa stamping, they didn't ask for like showing a blocked account with money 863 euros. They didn't ask for that.
Okay.
It was 853.
After this documentation part is completed, you also have to do some biometrics check, right?
Yes. Next thing you do is...
Could you tell about that?
Next thing you do is pay your fee. So you can pay it through card or you can pay it through cash. But cash is preferable because when I paid money through card, it was okay. But the next person who paid her payment got declined. But her money got detected. Then she had to again pay it through cash. So there might be like problems with that. The next thing you do is biometric. For me, there was a problem with the biometric device. So the fingerprints aren't scanning. So I had to wait for almost 30 minutes for their device to get right. And after 30 minutes, they called me for the biometrics. So that was the last part at VFS Hyderabad.
And so what kind of biometrics did you have to submit?
You have to submit all your fingers, like four fingers of your left and right hand, and then your thumbs.
Okay. This was the complete process, right? So biometrics is the end of the visa appointment day.
Yes, yes.
And after this, I think there is still one more step left, and that's like you have to decide how do you want to get the stamping done, right?
Yeah, that service was recently begun, that you can opt for a courier service, that they have this pick up and drop service. Yeah. But right now it is not in practice actually.
Okay, and in your case, how did you get your passport?
I have my visa stamping tomorrow.
Ah, okay, you have your visa stamping tomorrow.
Yes, yes, yes.
So you have to go there personally, right?
Yes, yes, I have to.
Okay, great.
Then you have your passport written through courier, but then for stamping you have to go in person.
Okay, great. Yeah, then thank you so much, Nikita, for detailed information.
And, thank you.
And I hope it will be useful for all the students applying from Hyderabad jurisdiction. And still, if the students have any doubt, then of course they will post in the comment section. So maybe you or I can answer in the comments.
Yeah. Yes, sure. I can do that.
Okay. So all the best for your stamping tomorrow.
Thank you.
I hope to see you here in Halle very soon.
Sure.
That's it for this video, guys. I hope you find this video really useful. If you like it, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up and also share it with your friends who has applied for visa from Hyderabad jurisdiction. So share this video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So see you in the next video. Till then, bye, take care and stay safe.